Hey all, I'm John Avalon, and this is Reality Check on the Extremist Beat. The Flat Earth Society. The name itself is a punchline, right? I'm talking about those truly committed conspiracy theorists who still believe, against literally all evidence, that the world is not round, but flat.
Daredevil Mad Mike Hughes is dead after he attempted to launch his homemade rocket Saturday. He eventually wanted to go into near orbit in his quest to prove his theory that the Earth is flat.
Now, we could talk about Copernicus or Columbus, the Ark of the Sun, space travel, or transnational flights that circumnavigate the globe every day. But no, these folks would still insist that the world is flat. And that itself offers real insights, actually, into the endurance of conspiracy theories and why some people so stubbornly cling to them. That's the subject of a great new book called Off the Edge, Flat Earthers, Conspiracy Culture, and Why People Will Believe Anything. The author is Kelly Weil, reporter on the extremism and internet beat at Mild site, The Daily Beast, and it is great to welcome her to Reality Check. Where did the modern incarnation of this very, very old idea get started?
Modern flat earth theory really emerged around the mid-1800s. It was really one guy's fault. He was a quack doctor, a conspiracy theorist, who started promoting flat earth theory based on his observations on a long straight canal, which he said looked perfectly flat, and therefore, to his eye, the rest of the world should be flat too. People wanted a simpler answer than ideas that might have been frightening. So flat earth theory took on this central role for people who wanted to discard emerging scientific thought, and unfortunately, it's stuck around since then.
We don't think the world's flat. We know that the world is flat because it is a law, actually. it's a law of physics, a law of God, a law of nature.
Charles Johnson is the president of the International Flat Earth Research Society. Its membership contains some 2,800 people who firmly believe the Earth is indeed flat.
I remember this from when I was reporting on the extremist beat and writing Wingnuts. There are always conspiracy entrepreneurs. Now, usually there's a partisan racket. It's right-wing talk TV, radio, blogs, podcasts. But what are the financial incentives off the Flat Earth Society? Who's making money off this?
So the Flat Earth universe right now is so much bigger even than the Flat Earth Society. The internet has really democratized conspiracy theories and made it so that anybody can start their own YouTube channel, their own podcast. Conspiracy videos are very, very lucrative online. They're so scintillating. If I see a video on YouTube with a crazy headline, something about Flat Earth, even though I don't believe in Flat Earth, I'm pretty tempted to click on that. So because these videos overperform on social media, they often get artificially boosted by social media sites' algorithms. And a lot of very savvy people on YouTube, on Facebook, picked up on that and they said, okay, I'm going to make the Flat Earth video because I know that's going to bring me money. So there is a whole shadow ecosystem to how people are engaging with Flat Earth, not necessarily because they believe in it. Some people do. Some people are a little bit more cynical. And these people are realizing that if you make conspiracy content, you're probably going to get some profit.
That is such an important and, in retrospect, obvious point. It's the algorithms. This is yet another example of the algorithms creating a perverse incentive structure that leads to totally absurd places, promoting cults and conspiracy theories.
That's true. And to YouTube's credit, they have, I think 2019, they started tinkering with the algorithm to delist Flat Earth videos. They realized we've got a real problem here. And now it's harder to find them. It's harder to accidentally stumble upon them. But to that end, I would say that the genie was already out of the bottle. Mm. These videos were everywhere for 5 years before they tamped down on that algorithm. So yeah, it's very hard to decouple the success of this conspiracy theory from the big tech companies that willingly or not made it really profitable.
When we come back, you'll hear about how to get people out of conspiracy theories and cults, including, of course, the Flat Earth Society. I get that in cults and conspiracy theories, particularly in the online era, the community is self-reinforcing, especially when people feel rejected by the rest of society for their beliefs. But what's the appeal of this particular conspiracy theory? Why flat Earth for these folks?
I think for flat Earth, it offers a whole vision of the universe. Another theory like QAnon or chemtrails, well, that's just a little part of a conspiracy universe. It sort of fits alongside the accepted reality that most of us share. Flat Earth is almost like a religion in its totality. Mm. If you believe it, then you have a whole new worldview. And alongside that, you have a whole new set of friends and people who share your ideas. When you buy into Flat Earth, it brings you into this community.
Your reporting also shows, though, this troubling overlap between the far right and the Flat Earthers. Explain, how did that work?
So there's no inherent reason there should be so many Flat Earth Nazis, and yet there are a lot of Flat Earth Nazis.
Flat Earth Nazis?
Yeah, we're talking fringe of the fringe. I think conspiracy theories are very powerful in political extremist movements because they are looking for alternative explanations. They're looking for often scapegoats for why they feel disempowered, why they feel angry.
I got to say, I didn't see Flat Earth Nazis coming. I want to end this on a hopeful note, as I am wont to do, and look at some useful solutions, particularly when you've interviewed folks who've left the Flat Earth Society. What was it that ultimately convinced them? Because it really could offer folks some tips about getting people out of cults overall, and God knows we need that right now.
One thing that came up again and again, talking to ex-Flat Earthers and also people who help others leave cults, was that you have to do it with empathy. I know sometimes that can be really hard because Flat Earth seems like an easy punchline, or sometimes it can be hard because someone believes in a conspiracy theory that's morally reprehensible to you, like QAnon is to me. But offering someone empathetic conversation about why they believe what they do and why those beliefs might be false, and then giving them a safe place to land when they exit the conspiracy theory. I've spoken to so many conspiracy theorists who are worried about what happens when they try to go back to the friends and family they alienated. Will those people make fun of them? Will they point and laugh and say you were wrong? And I think the most helpful thing that you can do is welcome people back and bring them back to reality gently. Give them a safe landing place.
Such an important point. And as you say, it's completely consistent with what we've learned from talking to people who've left cults, from people who focus on this. The empathy, the understanding, the safe landing, the safe harbor, if you will. Kelly Weil, congrats on the book. It's great to see you. It's great to have you on Reality Check. Be well.
Thank you, John.